everyone. In this video, we are going to talk about the relative density. So before going to the relative density, let us look at what is density of a substance first of all. Now we have already discussed it. This is just a brush up of the same concept. Now suppose we have a wooden block and we want to take out a piece out of it which has a volume of 1 cm³. Now on cutting out such a piece, we have this piece with volume 1 cm³, which is a unit volume, and this piece must be having some mass, right? Now when we zoom in this piece, we see that it has a structure like this, which where the particles are stuffed into it. Now these particles must be having some mass. Now this amount of mass, which is contained in a volume of 1 cm³ or any kind of unit volume like 1 m³, is what we called the density of that particular substance. So in this case, the density of a material is given by mass per unit volume. That is, density equals mass divided by volume. And we have also seen that the SI unit in which the density of a substance is measured is kg/m³, and also it is measured in terms of g/cm³. Now, with this, let us go to the concept of relative density. Now, density here is unique for a particular substance under specified conditions. It doesn't change for a particular substance. So this makes it a characteristic property of that substance, which is different for different substances. So the density of a particular substance is not equal to the density of another substance with the same physical conditions, physical and chemical conditions. Now, the relative density of a substance is the ratio of its density to the density of water. So the formula to this is relative density of a substance is given by the density of the substance divided by the density of water. Now here what we are doing is basically we are finding the density of the substance with respect to water. We are comparing it with the density of water, and that is why we have the term to be relative density. This basically means that it is the density of a substance related to water or with respect to water, or as compared to water, you can say. Any of these mean the same. Now here we see that in both numerator and denominator of this formula, we have density. So their units are the same, so they cancel out, with leaving the relative density to be unitless. So the relative density of any substance is unitless. It has no unit at all. It is simply a number. Now, here in this table, I have shown some of the substances with their respective relative densities. For wood, it is 0.8. You can clearly see that I have not mentioned any kind of unit there, neither in the table or head of the table, or even I have not mentioned any unit down there. So the water has a relative density of 1, and it is 2.5 for glass, and iron's relative density is 7.8, and for mercury it is 13.6. So these are some of the substances with their relative densities. Now, let's say we have this density formula, which is density of the substance is mass per unit volume, that is mass divided by volume. Now, we know that the relative density of a substance equals the density of that substance divided by the density of water, as we have discussed in the previous slide. Now here, density of the substance which is there in the numerator can be brought into this form by using that formula above. So here the density of the substance is replaced by mass of the substance divided by volume of the substance, divided by density of water is replaced by mass of the substance divided by volume, mass of the water divided by volume of water. Now in writing the same expression in this form, we have mass of the substance divided by volume of the substance multiplied by volume of water divided by mass of water. Now when we take equal volumes of the substance and the water, then we can get these two terms cancelled out. Since the volumes are equal, we have taken equal volumes of the substance as well as water. Now on cancelling this, we have the relative density to be mass of the substance divided by the mass of an equal volume of water. Now, As we saw here that the relative density of the substance is the ratio of the mass of the substance and an equal mass of an equal volume of water. So this is another way of defining the relative density of a substance in terms of masses of these two things, that is the substance and the water. Previously we have defined the relative density in terms of the density of the substance and the density of water. So here we have defined it in terms of the mass of the substance and mass of water. Now the relative density of a substance expresses the heaviness of the substance as compared to water. Heaviness or the density as compared to water. Now basically it means that when we say that the relative density of mercury is 13.6, it basically means that we are saying that relative the mercury is 13.6 times heavier than an equal volume of water. So by saying that the relative density of mercury is 13.6, we mean this, that is the mercury is 13.6 times heavier than an equal volume of water. So this is the essence of the concept of relative density. So with this we have come to the end of this video, and I hope the concept of relative density was clear to you. Thanks for watching.
TutorialsPoint.com. Simply easy learning.